Calculator techniques for derivatives. So kung meron tayong multiple choice questions about finding derivatives, pwede natin itong masolve using calculator techniques. So for the first problem, let's find dy over dx if y is equal to the cube root of 3x squared plus 3x plus 1 quantity squared. So unang step is gamitin natin yung derivative function ng calc u. So press shift followed by this derivative button. And then input natin yung y in terms of x. So let's input the cube root. So shift cube root. And then open parenthesis 3 alpha x squared plus 3 alpha x plus 1 close parenthesis quantity squared. And then mag-assign kayo ng kahit anong value ng x, let's say 5. Okay, press equal. And then store natin tong value sa isang variable, let's say sa a. So shift store a. So next step is isa-isahin natin yung mga choices, evaluate doon sa same value ng x na sinet natin, which is 5. So kapag nag-equal yung na-solve natin sa pag-evaluate ng bawat choice doon sa 5, then yun yung tamang sagot. So pwede nyong gawin is sa bawat na-evaluate yung value ng given choice, i-divide nyo lang siya doon sa in-store nating value doon sa a. Kapag equal to 1, ibig sabihin, yun na yung tamang sagot. So sige, let's start with choice a. Yung 2x plus 1 over cube root of 3x squared plus 3x plus 1. So input lang natin yung expression. So fraction, we have for the numerator is 2 alpha x plus 1 over shift cube root 3 alpha x squared plus 3 alpha x plus 1. Then calc natin dun sa sinet nating value ng x, which is 5. Equal. Okay. Then try natin i-divide doon sa alpha a kung mag-i-equal siya sa 1. Okay, so hindi nag-equal sa 1, ibig sabihin hindi a yung tamang sagot. So proceed kayo sa letter b, which is 4x plus 2 over cube root of 3x squared plus 3x plus 1. So input lang natin. So we have fraction, numerator is 4x plus 2, so 4 alpha x plus 2 over shift cube root 3 alpha x squared plus 3 alpha x plus 1. And then, i-calc din natin sa same value ng x, which is 5. So, press equal. Okay, try nating i-divide ngayon sa alpha a kung mag-i-equal sa 1. Okay, so since nag-equal sa 1, therefore, yung tamang sagot is letter B. Next, let's have number 2. Find dy over dx if y is equal to cosine of quantity square root of x squared plus 1 plus 1. Okay, so this time meron tayong derivative ng trigonometric function. So kapag meron kayong derivative ng trigo function, it's safe na i-convert nyo yung mode ng calc nyo sa radian. So dahil naka-degree mode tayo, i-convert natin siya sa radian. So press shift, setup, and then piliin natin yung 4 for radian. Okay? So para safe, kapag magka-calculate kayo for derivatives, lagi nyo nalang iset sa radian mode yung calc. Okay? So ngayon, unang step, again, hanapin natin yung derivative ng given function y using the derivative button ng calc. So press shift, derivative, and then input natin yung cosine square root of x squared plus 1 plus 1. So cosine, then we have square root, so alpha x squared plus 1, then plus 1, close parenthesis. So, evaluate natin, let's say, sa any value ng x na gusto nyo, as long as hindi magiging undefined yung sagot. Let's say, 5 na lang ulit. Okay? So, store natin to sa letter A. So, shift store A. Okay? Then, isa-isahin uli natin yung choices. So, dun muna tayo sa A. Negative x sine of quantity square root of x squared plus 1 plus 1 over square root of x squared plus 1. So, i-calc natin yan sa same value ng x, which is 5. So, input muna natin. So, let's have negative fraction. For the numerator, we have alpha x, then sine, square root of alpha x squared plus 1, then plus 1, close parenthesis, down, over the square root of alpha x squared plus 1. Okay, and then ikakalk natin sa same value ng x, which is 5. Press equal. Okay, then divide natin sa alpha a kung mag-i-equal sa 1. So since nag-equal sa 1, ibig sabihin, letter a yung tamang sagot. Okay, it's your turn. So try nyo namang sagutan yung problem na to and just comment your answer.